मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू माय क्लास ऑल स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 3. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट द समरी ऑफ एसएसटी चैप्टर 1 to 6. स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी नो दैट इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस ऑल द 6 चैप्टर्स. इन दिस क्लास वी विल ओनली डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स ऑफ ऑल दिस चैप्टर्स. So let's start our revision class. Students, in this term, our first chapter is family and its type. In this chapter, we will discuss what is family, how many types of family, working parents, birth of a baby, marriage in the family. Okay, so this is the points of in this chapter. First we start, what is family? A family is a group of people comprising parents and children. Family is the most important thing for an individual. It is a place where one develops emotional attachment with one another. Okay, there are two types of family: joint family and a nuclear family. Joint family, a family, a large in divided family where more than one generation live together in a common house is called a joint family. Nuclear family, a family consists of parents and children is called a nuclear family. Nuclear family generally found in the urban and metropolitan areas. Okay, working parents. In today's modern time, family life is changing, and so it is the role of mother and father at home and at work. In such family, there is a division of work between parents. They understand and cooperate each other. Okay, this is the working parents definition. Birth of a child, the arrival of a new baby. Okay, birth of a baby, the arrival of a new baby brings many changes to a family. Parents spend a lot of time and energy in the preparation for the little new member of the house, and a child establishes a brand new relationship with the little one. Marriage in the family. You must have attended marriage of an elder cousin or young uncle or auntie. Marriage is an occasion of joy and salvation in the family. Okay. During the ceremonies of marriage, everyone is dressed up nicely and dances to express his or her joy for the newly married couple. Okay. So this is the definition of marriage in the family. And our second chapter is Changes in neighborhood and school. Change is the law of nature. Okay. Change is what? Change is the law of nature. Life does not remain same. People change houses. Kids change their school. And friends shift away. Children probably have to face a new teacher every year. Okay, so it's very important that we learn to cope up with the various changes of life. Okay, in this chapter we will discuss some points and changes in lifestyle, changes in food. Okay, so changes in lifestyle. Lifestyle is the way in which a person or group lives. The nature of neighborhood also affects the lifestyle of a person. Lifestyle of working parents, single parents and homemakers are also different. Okay, in the second point, changes in food. We all need food to survive. Indian food heavily influenced by religion and cultural choices and tradition. Each state of India has different food preferences. Okay, changes in work. The scientific and technological innovation have certainly licensed. Manual labor. The computer revolution has dramatically changed the nature of work. Okay, changes in clothes. Along with the changes in our lifestyle, working culture and social norms. Okay, working culture and social norms, traditional wares are losing their significance very fast among today youth. Fashion designers are developing new designs day in, day out. However, traditional dresses are still in vogue. Changes in houses. Nowadays, there are major changes in houses. Bungalow, flats, and multi-storage buildings are built with the expertise of an architects and engineers. Friends, changes of school. What is the reasons when children changes in school? Changes in school. There are many situations when a child needs to change school. Some of them probable reasons might be as follow: moving to another city or country, parents getting transferred due to work, problems at old school. Okay, students, it's important to open to new things. And we must keep patience and accept new things only in a new environment. So this is our second chapter, and our third chapter is changes in transport system. What is our third chapter? Changes in transport. Students, in this chapter we will discuss how many types of transport. Okay, what is transport system? What is the development in the transportation system today? Today, every distance is achievable. It is just become because of the improvements of transportation and communication available worldwide. The means of transport is divided into three parts: land, air, and water transport. Okay. The means of transport is divided into three parts: land, water, and air transport. First, we start land transport. Land transport includes roads and railways. India has the largest network of road. Okay. India has the largest network of road. And the major roads connecting state capitals and important cities in India and are called the national highways. Okay, the highest elevated road in the world is the Leh Manali road. Okay, so this is the land transport. In air transport is the fastest and most. Air transport is the fastest and most advanced means of transportation system. Airways are useful during disaster for providing rescue operations. Okay, and airways travel by air is comfortable, but it is not cost effective. Okay, and the water transport. The progress of a water country largely depend on a good water transport network. Many rivers in India are suitable for the water transport. The main 30 seaports in India are 30 seaports in India. Okay. The different means of transport system has made our life more comfortable and advanced. So this is our third chapter. And the fourth chapter is gender sensitivity. What is our fourth chapter? Gender sensitivity. In this chapter, gender sensitivity is a contemporary topic. It is the concept of being sensitivity to the ways people think about the gender. The main purpose of the concept of gender sensitivity is to make the student understand that gender is not a barrier for any activity or occupation. Gender equality benefits both women and men as it provides them wider options. our constitution clearly says that there is equal pay for equal work for the both men and women. In this chapter, we learn how women have proved themselves, okay, in every area of and part of life. First, for example, Indira Gandhi was the third Prime Minister of India. She has been Prime Minister of India in two phases, okay. And Kalpana Chawla was an Indian American astronaut. And Sania Mirza is the most successful woman Indian tennis player. PV Sindhu. So in this chapter we will learn women have proved themselves in every area and part of life. So this is our fourth chapter, and our fifth chapter is concept of time. What is our fifth chapter? Concept of time. Students, prehistoric people did not have any device. Okay. Prehistoric people do not have any device to know the actual time. They began their work with the sunrise and finished it before sunset. Okay. The sandal was used by the people in early days. It is a device that tells the time of day by the position of the sun. Okay. Then came the time stick. What is came? Then came the time stick, which were used in India, Tibet, and some parts of Europe. Then came pendulum clock in 1656, and quartz clocks were made in 1927. And now atomic clocks have been developed, which are the most accurate timekeeping device in practical use today. Students, you know how to measure the time? In this chapter, we will discuss how to measure time. Okay, 60 seconds, 1 minute, 60 minutes, 1 hour, 24 hours, 1 day, 7 days, 1 week, 4 weeks, 1 month, 12 months, 1 year. Okay, so this is the measure of the time, telling the time. The days begin with the rising of the sun. It is called the morning. Okay. It is the time to start our day. And we see around 12 p.m. the sun high up in the sky. And we call it noon. Okay. So in this chapter. And when it is dark, we call it night. During the night, the moon and the stars are seen in the sky. It is the time for the dinner and go to the bed. Uses of timeline. Timelines are very useful for understanding the chronology or order of historical, political, economic and social trends and events. Students can trace the date of birth of their family members on a timeline in a chronological order. Okay, so this is the uses of timeline. In our last chapter, calendar. What is our last chapter? Calendar. In this term, this is our last chapter, calendar. Calendar is a chart or series of pages showing days, weeks and months of a particular year. So there are many calendars, yet the Gregorian calendar is used in all over the world. This calendar was introduced in 1582 by Pope Gregory XIII. Okay, in this calendar, this was introduced in 1582 by Pope Gregory XIII. Structure of calendar, January is the first month and the December is the last month. 12 hours, 1 day, 1 week, 7 days. Okay, and there are 4 or 5 weeks in a month. So, this is the structure of calendar. Students, significations of calendar. A calendar is more than just dates. It tells us about different events and stories about our communities. There are a number of reasons why we need calendar. Okay. So, let's start. Planning the daily activities become much easier with a calendar to keep a track of events, sharing, organize and enhancing productivity. Okay. So, this is the structure of calendar. So, thank you. Have a nice day.